They treat us like we're stupid.
Some residents frustrated with city council gathered to fight back with a petition. A major pushback tonight against Cincinnati's controversial parking proposal. Good evening, everyone, and thanks for joining us. I'm Curtis Fuller. City Council has given the thumbs up to lease most of its parking to help ease budget problems. But now there's an effort to put that decision in the hands of voters. WLWT News 5's Laura Borchers has more tonight on what's being done to try to block the deal.
A huge controversy has parked itself right in front of these meters. Most of City Council has decided to lease them out over the next 30 years for $92 million to feed the deficit. But opposition fears that's going to leave you paying more to park and for longer hours. So they filed a restraining order, and now they're getting a petition started.
I have called, I have petitioned, I have emailed, and I get two responses from two offices, Mr. Sittefeld and Mr. Smitherman. That's it.
Frustrated Cincinnatians like Jim Kiefer made their way to Oakley Square. They're determined to do what they can to stop the parking deal.
I don't like giving away public assets.
Mark Fiss signed the petition after studying up on other cities that leased out parking. He says if customers have to pay more to park, including nighttime hours, it'll kill business.
We think that this is not only a bad plan for neighborhood business districts, but every resident in the city of Cincinnati.
This petition drive launch is intended to put a boot on the city ordinance. These folks spent their Sunday telling Cincinnatians they need to stand up to prevent council from leasing the city's parking for decades just to get an upset budget windfall. These volunteers and politicians banded together all afternoon in a relentless effort.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week, right?
They collected hundreds of signatures and said some people even registered to vote so they could join the petition. They want to overwhelmingly surpass the 7,500 signatures needed to add the issue to your ballot. Even that can only happen if the restraining order helps prevent council's emergency decision.
Six members of council took that away from the citizens of Cincinnati by passing this ordinance by emergency.
We talked with one of the council members who voted for leasing off the meters. Yvette Simpson calls it a necessary sacrifice.
We get to take an underutilized asset. We get to use it for our operating deficit, which is very real in the short term. But we also get to take a majority of the money and put it in places where we can grow our pie.
Simpson explains money will go to the pension fund, city projects, and most importantly, prevent layoffs.
Making cuts, right, to public services will almost certainly be detrimental to our neighborhoods and our business districts.
Members of council wanted this deal to go through without citizens to look at it. That's obvious.
Their goal is 20,000 signatures. This coming Friday, Judge Winkler will make his decision on the restraining order on this issue. At City Hall, I'm Laura Borchers, WLWT News 5.
Now, just a footnote to this story. According to the city manager, Milton Dehoney, without this parking plan in place, the city is prepared to lay off hundreds of employees, including police and fire positions.